Welcome to Unfiltered, I'm SE Cupp. A public high school in Florida is facing a wave of backlash after it altered 80 yearbook photos of young girls to cover their cleavage or shoulders. Girls like freshman Riley O'Keefe were stunned to open their yearbook and find a black bar had been placed over their cleavage. Another freshman, Brooke, who asked not to use her last name, found her flannel shirt had been digitally altered to cover more of her chest. After parents complained, pointing to the vagueness of the dress code policy, which prohibits clothes that are, quote, immodest, revealing, or distracting, the superintendent agreed there was an insufficient review of the process before the photos were edited. He promised changes in how that process occurs going forward and offered refunds for yearbooks to anyone who wanted one. The story, unsurprisingly, made national news, with strong opinions on both sides. You know what? I'll get back to the yearbook story in a minute. But first, I don't know if any of you have spent any time on TikTok, the quote-unquote dance app that's taken the world by storm. I'm obsessed with it because I'm not a regular mom. I'm a cool mom. But really, I'm just impressed. It's not just for dancing, of course. Although, if you're familiar with the D'Amelios or Addison Rae, dancing is a great place to start. But it's for all kinds of things. Skits, life hacks, product reviews. And I've long been telling my colleagues in the Jurassic TV business that some of the most creative producers right now are on TikTok. Anyway, if you've perused a For You page, you might have come across some scantily clad teens in bikinis gyrating to the latest TikTok song, or proudly showing off their crop top and short shorts outfit of the day. While as a parent, I shudder at the thought of having to raise our kids in this era of oversharing and exhibitionism and social media, I also look at these kids having fun and proudly showing off their bodies and think, man, I wish I'd had that kind of confidence. The confidence of Remy Bader, a 26-year-old plus-size model on TikTok who does realistic clothing hauls from popular outlets. Her body positivity is honestly, in my opinion, one of the best things for young girls to see on social media right now. So instead, in high school, this was me. I was maybe 16 or 17, there with my dad, posing in front of the theater where I performed with Boston Ballet. This was my preferred dress, covered head to toe, long skirts, baggy sweaters, oversized coat. I don't think my cleavage made an appearance in a photo or otherwise until college. I had to learn how to smile with my teeth after hiding braces for so long. I had to learn how to do makeup after not wanting to draw any attention to myself. I had to get over years of body issues and eating disorders to prove that my weight wasn't my worth. I had to teach myself that being content with my figure, unashamed of showing it off, didn't mean I was a slut or asking for trouble. It took me a long time and a lot of self-hate. I also had to learn that I wasn't responsible for the predation or sexualizing of minor girls by older men. I wasn't responsible, for example, when a guest lecturer at my school, a scientist from a nearby lab, slipped me a note with his phone number on it after class. I was 13. He was in his 30s. The lessons we teach young girls about their bodies and their worth will stay with them the rest of their lives. These are formative years, and puberty is confusing enough as it is. The dangerous part of the Florida story is that in this moment, it taught girls to be ashamed of their bodies and to protect the boys from their raging hormones. None of that is going to serve these kids well. Now look, as a mom, I may decide certain clothes aren't appropriate for my kid at school. I may decide to monitor or limit my kid's activities on social media. That's all my right as a parent. And every parent has their own line, their own views on this. But it's not up to a school to decide what immodest means or to cover up our girls' bodies arbitrarily without much explanation, to leave them feeling confused, ashamed, or to blame. If we want to raise confident, responsible, secure young women, we need to give them these tools. And we've come a long way. Kudos to the parents who complained on behalf of their daughters. But episodes like these in Florida set us back decades. Okay, that's it for me. See you next week.